to me, for one thing, they should have one thing that's for people who are underage to give them, you know, because most of the time you see those that are saying that looking for people that are under something like that. I would think that they should have a thing just to make it a little bit easier on them. But truthfully, I would also have folders for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, that if you're going to want to play on a certain day, you post in that folder.
Yeah. Age is a tricky thing because there's lots of interesting laws when you're posting things where you're explicitly allowing people under a certain age to participate. Like Disney ran into a lot of issues with that with some of their early online things, getting hit a lot by the state of California because they have that. I used to know what all the laws were, but there's a.
Or if it'd be better to say a folder that said, you know, 18 above only.
Yeah, that might be easy.
Age verified. Oh yeah, but legally, if they see it, then it's, you know,
it's on them. It's not on you.
Yeah,
they lied. You did what you had to. They lied to get in. Everyone, all 15, 16, 17-year-olds lie and say they're older. It's just what they do. But it's on them if they see something that they shouldn't.
Yeah. Well, and I used to play Second Life quite a bit. And there's a very adult aspect to that because you're playing with other people. And then, there are people that will have virtual sex and stuff like that. So it's an 18 or above game. They had for a long time, they had for younger. But that ended up failing. And I knew a few people that were playing the main game that were underage. One was 17. The other one was 16. But his mother also played. So she was aware that he was in it. And I never reported anything. So...
yeah, Second Life is another one of those places where age rules are really weird there. Like,
yeah.
Children are allowed to access the game. Children are allowed to access even areas that are rated adult, as long as the part of the adult region that they are in does not contain nudity or explicit acts.
Yeah.
Like, but then why have the adult designation? Is that like the safety net in case a wall?
Well, there's actually like an invisible border that their character cannot physically walk across. There's a barrier. They're blocked.
But okay.
The thing is, you can set the camera to go beyond what normal would, that where you could pan the whole land. So you could go in there and watch people doing things.
Yeah.
And I mean, and it's real easy to pop in on things that you don't know, because there are a lot of the names. You don't know what it is when you go searching for groups or something. You could put in something very innocuous, and then all of a sudden you go and it's like, oh, okay. Or, you know, I was going to message a friend of mine in the game. And instead of clicking to send, I clicked to send myself too. Well, she was busy with her girlfriend at the time. And I was like, whoops, sorry.
Look, all right. Especially like upper teenagers, 16, 17, they're going to get into whatever the hell they want to get into. There's no stopping them. But yeah. I mean, not quite the same. I was reading Game of Thrones when I was like 12. Yeah, no, it's teenagers will be teenagers, and there's no stopping them.
Yeah, and I mean that's something.
What we do is we protect ourselves, by putting you same thing that says you have to be 18. That way, you can't get in trouble because somebody underage lied to get into to see stuff.
Yeah, well, and that's the thing that basically. Being gay, that I'm always very aware of, that, you know, I will tell people, I'm like, no, you know, if you're having a kid, you know, in the thing, I'm leaving, or we have to be extremely cool, because, you know, people are like, you're gay, oh my god, you're trying to indoctrinate my child, you know.
Look,
so
the world is going to hell, and it's especially America. And let's just leave it with that. I've had a rough last week.
Yeah, they can't build shuttles to get me out of here fast enough.
It's like, oh, you hate it so much, why don't you just leave the country? With what money? Where's all of this money that it takes to move coming from, exactly?
That again, it's our country too, so why the hell should we move? They're the ones that have the problem, and they're actually the minority.
You're not wrong. But not much we can do about it.
All right, server should be back up. Hopefully you all can log in now. Looks like Baldur will not be making it tonight either, so it will just be the three of you that will be dying.
Well, one thing I did learn yesterday, if we bring up their character sheets, we can actually roll as them.
Yes.
So, I mean, we can use their character, and you don't even have to.
If the three of us die because no one else is here, I vote our next characters get some awesome
something. No, I'm saying we're going to have their characters there, but we're going to be running them.
Well, Brett has left, so his character is presumably...
It's
there pretty, isn't well, anybody who will be
well, it's not in upset. The system anymore, so no. We can't bring well, up his
character sheet is still there. It's just level 5, I believe. But his character is, and I believe Ricky and Gil, you still have your alternates, correct?
I think I will probably have to, because I think last we used him, he was probably 4, so I may have to level him to 5 real fast then.
Yeah, everybody's level 6, but I think there have been 2 level ups since you brought the alt.
Yeah, see, I've got release listed as level 4, so hang
and
on.
If you need an extra alternate, I'm happy to bring in my druid that I had free built for the game.
Sure, go for it. What's your name, and I can create a token?
It's already over in D&D Beyond.
Okay.
Raltosh.
Okay, is that the one that was showing as not connected?
Yes.
Okay.
I figured that way people can see it if they want to see future options.
All right, yeah, give me 1 second. I'll make a token for it.
If we need backup characters, at least the character's already ready.
Yeah, I mean, I don't see why not. Right.
That means I can choose 4 more spells. Never seen this spell before. It's necromancy, 1 black fire? Or is that a homebrew? Where would it say source?
Usually if you scroll all the way to the bottom of the description, it'll say source in italics in the bottom right corner.
Okay, no. No.
So
it doesn't. Okay.
Okay. So
it black fire. I mean, it sounds interesting. I was like, oh, okay. But I'm guessing this blossom of flesh must be the one too. Yeah, someone must have added, in one of my groups, someone must have added a whole bunch of necrotic homebrew stuff or something, because it's like, oh, where's this coming from? Corpse Fires, another one. It's like, whoa.
I was looking at my character, I'm like, how do I have access to my backup character? How do I have access to a 6th level spell? That's right. Magic items.
I don't know. I don't think I had anything on mine that was homebrew to begin with, so I don't know why it would be I would have homebrew on.
Yeah,
it was turned on for me, but it was like I thought I had turned it off. I might have turned it back on accidentally.
I think it may just be D&D Beyond is not doing a good job of keeping things separated.
Yeah.
Like, I'm looking, I did a search of the official book, and there's entries in here that have code in them. That can't possibly be valid items. Permissions. Oh.
And it always confuses me where they have two of the same spell from different books. Like, once Leomund's Tiny Hut, and then you have Tiny Hut. They're basically the same thing. So it's like...
So technically, any spell that has a name in it, you have to pay a small fee to the person who created it, according to one of the books. They are essentially copyrighted.
That would be up to them to pay, not us.
No, it's a... It...
Basically, I think either when you learn it or when you cast it,
Every time you cast it, it's like a silver or gold or copper, depending on the level of the spell.
Yeah, you basically have to send them a royalty check.
Yeah. I think it's described in the... what's the...
It's in the Cauldron of Everything, right?
No, it's the game. It's not homebrew, but with the wonder, I'm blanking on what it's called because I want to play that campaign in that world, but it'll come to me in a second. The one with the really famous game, Ak-Ink. It's the Ak-Ink stuff.
Don't know that one.
Acquisitions Incorporated?
Oh, okay. That I've
heard
of, at least, I think.
It's fun. I really want to play something in there. It's just because I really like the where you get your company position. There's some real fun things you can do with that.
I guess I'll take Fireball.
What?
Okay.
Well, okay. So did I.
Well, for some reason, I have two Rotoruses.
You've got three, I think, but yeah. I mean...
Mine is Release. My character's name.
Yeah. All right. Just when you update one of the Rotoruses, that's the one I'll drag into the screen. Oh, okay. The third one is from Wild Shape. That's why. Delete that one.
I am having a little bit of issues with my character because it's not showing me the spells I get from my staff.
For Jax or for Rel'Tash?
For Rel'Tash.
Okay, let's see.
I know what the spells are, but... It's kind of a crazy thing for only being considered rare.
Okay.
So, give us a lovely place to camp. If we don't want to camp on the ground.
And release is now updated.
Grotaurus, Adril Tash.
I have no clue what one would even be like. Because, I mean, I've never even read into any of the books.
I still maintain I want to play an Ak Inc. game, or like at least incorporate the rules of Acquisitions Incorporated into another game where we get it to be your own branch.
We can... All right. So for Reltash, I'm basically going to add the spells into the staff itself, and hopefully you will be able to cast them from there.
Cool.
And we'll see how well this works.
Oh, the staff? It is kind of a crazy, powerful object. It's considered rare. We were said told that we could get a rare item for our backup character.
Oh, well, I should put something on release then. I never got that.
That's what I was told for when we were creating our characters for when our
Although release would not be a permanent one. I just did him at the time.
Right. And that was right.
A lot lower level. This was,
and yeah, those were all created at level 4 too.
This was
but yeah, if you want to add if you want to add a rare item, you can. Text editor.
After the woodlands is ridiculous.
Probably to oh god, what's the grimoire? Arcane.
You may be able to search at least the items that I have imported by hitting Control Spacebar, and that'll pop up a search, and you can at least, if it works for players, you may be able to search in that. I have not actually tested that.
Item. Where do we search? In game.
Yeah, just in game when you're clicked on the world, not in the sidebar. Hit Control Spacebar, and you may get a search window that pops up.
Blue is the rare.
All right, so if you open up Reltash and look at the staff, down at the bottom it should have the spells.
I actually can't see any of my equipment for whatever reason. It's all vanished. No.
That is not good.
Wait, never mind, found it. Something went weird when I clicked it. There we go.
Okay.
Yes.
It might have been because I was updating it. Okay.
But I also was unable to see, like, my scimitar or my armor. Yeah. But I do see it now.
Okay. Not entirely sure if it's possible to cast from there.
And I doubt it's going to keep track of the...
It's not going to keep track of the charges, no.
I will have to do that on my own.
I think I can make it... Oh, no.
You don't have to use that now, though.
Spells. Yeah. I could probably think of something for that at some point, but... This is definitely not something that was made for your virtual tabletop.
No. I still maintain I'm stunned this is considered rare.
And you guys are still looking for the items that you're going for the rare item you're going to add to Rotoris and Raleigh's, correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
I put one on release just for now, since until I actually make a backup one, I would have to decide first what I'd want.
All right.
Rel'Tash just doesn't speak. Ever. Have fun.
I'll probably quicker if I just... What's the name going to be? I'm just temporary name that is horribly misspelled and will update when you update it. Just give me one moment to change the permissions. Owner. Fault observer. Okay. It should now be showing up in the alts category. Yeah, if you do the D&D Beyond import, it'll update it.
I guess you can move Xander to alt or something if you want.
Yeah.
You should almost find a way of copying Zotora and make it an unassigned character, so if we get someone else, they could take it if they want.
For which one? For Xandar?
For Brett's character.
Yeah, I can. I don't have the D&D Beyond character. He took it out of the campaign. I do have the character still in the tabletop, so if somebody wants yeah, if somebody doesn't have time to create a character, they can pull that one in.
Oh yeah, I didn't even think about it. Several of my other games I've done new tokens for the group, and people seem to like them. So I'll show you a couple that I've done. One was done based on Magic the Gathering. Here, let's see, I'll put that here in general.
Ooh, nice.
That's very cool. And then I did some that were going to be more original, but the circle one, sometimes people are like, oh, well, you can't see that real well. And I'm like, okay. And then I also did some based off of Poke cards. Let me see if I can find.
What happened? What?
And then that one is the Pokemon based.
Yeah. Sorry about that. We will continue the journey momentarily. I did post a book that the shopkeeper that sold you all the cold weather gear gave you. It may be relevant to this journey. It may not. Who knows?
Okay. That, that the shield maiden oath seems like a very reasonable and good thing to swear to.
Yep. One of the challenging things with these maps is they're not strictly the D&D Beyond Curse of Strahd. They're pulling from some other source material as well that I haven't been able to find. So if there's good documentation for it, I go with it. If not, I stick to the core. Right. So,
and I need to run the washroom. I'll be right back.
All right. How's the import going? Okay, great. Yeah, I'm seeing the same, both for it and for the token. Let's see. They're very creative in their effort to keep you from stealing these images. copy, paste. Yeah.
Quick question.
Yep.
Sort of, hopefully not relevant yet. In beast shape, would my character be able to speak telepathically?
What is the ability that would let you speak telepathically when not in beast shape?
The fact that I'm a Kalashtar.
Ah. It's a racial...
You get to keep some things, even some racial things, but not all racial things. It's
right.
Really weirdly written.
Yeah. Is it listed as a cantrip, or how is it a feature, or...
Let me find it for a second.
Okay, I'm back.
Okay.
Hope, let me
all right.
Get into Twitch. I forgot to restart it.
Tip token appearance. That appearance is correct. Better.
What's the link you sent, Gil?
I have seen that before.
Like my language.
If you guys send me a copy of the image you want to use, I can play with the tokens thing and make something for you guys.
Mine is already up on D&D Beyond. Can you pull it from that?
It may be kind of small if I do.
Because I think I just pulled one of the pre-generated D&D Beyond images.
Oh. No, you did a figure from Hero Forge. No, this is, I'm looking at Jax.
Yeah. Oh, no, not for Jax, for Real Tosh. Sorry, I thought you were talking about for Jax.
Yeah.
For Jax. I can send you the Hero Forged. I just kind of...
Yeah.
When creating it, was going with generic Spartan looking character.
All right. Well, I'm always looking at images. If I find anything that I think you might like, I'll send it to you too. So if you want to switch, but I can make one using the Hero Forge. You can just. Because I'm constantly looking up images to make.
Let me see if I can find it. It's been a while.
All right. In the meantime, everyone ready to continue your journey into the mountains?
That was not yep.
Right. Yep.
All right. So you have been proceeding along a road known as Solenka Pass, slowly making your way up into the mountains. As you have made your journey, the snow has gone from light flurries to not quite a blizzard as you find yourselves emerging from the mountainous outcroppings and see a large gate that appears to be blocking your path. get everybody in town.
Aren't we going to say the Retorus joined us since...
Are you bringing the others and will be protecting them with you on this journey, or did you leave them behind in town?
As much as I would love to have their help, I kind of feel like it would be in bad form for us to...
Well, and truthfully, and now that we've upgraded Release, he's actually stronger spell-wise than Baldur is.
Okay.
And I know what that is. Because you forgot I could see it on the screen.
All right.
I'd say you forgot everyone could see it on the screen, but I was the only one looking.
Whether Reltash would be there or not, you probably won't notice her if she doesn't want to be found. Let's just leave it with that.
All right. So, the shelf of rock on which the mountain road clings grows narrow. To your left, the icy cliffs rise sharply toward dark, rolling clouds. To your right, the ground falls away into a sea of fog. Ahead, through the wind and snow, you see a high wall of black stone lined with spikes and topped by statues of demonic vultures with horned heads. Set in the center of the wall is a closed iron portcullis, behind which burns a curtain of green flame. On the other side of the dark wall, gripping the mountain's edge, is a guard tower of white stone topped by golden statues of mighty warriors. What would you all like to do?
Or Baldur through. Yeah, I was going to say, I'll move forward. What would be...
know if we want to say that Reltash is with us, and if so, if anyone has a reason why Reltash is with us, but...
He was picked up in the...
Could have been a traveler that was heading along the road that you joined up with.
Reltash does not look to humans and does not talk to humans.
Ah.
Or humanoids. Reltash has been living in the woods for the last couple of years, talking to no one. Ever.
Then these may have been the first people seen along this road in quite some time, and maybe is following out of curiosity, especially if they were drawn into the fog and brought to Barovia because they got lost.
Yeah, I keep saying that I'm walking into a wall, but I'm like, there's no wall there.
It's really hard to tell what's wall, what's... I didn't try to go down. I was unable to do anything else.
I did not realize. I thought it was all one level.
Ah, there we go.
There we go. Yeah, some of the characters may have gotten placed too close to the edge of that slope.
Hang on, let me see.
If Rultash is following them out of curiosity, she is definitely not shaped humanoid. She is wild shaped.
Okay. What shape would she be taking on?
Don't know if I'm allowed to do this. I liked the looks of the chimeric cat. Otherwise, a squirrel. Squirrels tend to be innocuous.
Well, I mean, remember the area that we're in. It's really cold, so the squirrel might not be the best.
My next form that would be good for the cold is a dire wolf. She's trying to not be noticed.
Why do I not have a wolf?
I think we would notice a dire wolf.
Yes, you would. Dire wolf is for fighting. Chimeric cat is for sneaking and for noticing things, because chimeric cats are weird and have blind sense and tremor sense.
Well, I'm going to turn you into an elk because it's the only thing that I have. And that did not work the way I expected.
It's a funny looking squirrel.
Or cat.
Alright.
We'll debate if it's a cat or the squirrel later.
Alright, let's see if this works. Where'd that elk go? There it
is. Look.
There. You are now an elk.
Cool. There. Happy?
Yeah, sure. Say,
the echo to walk through them? See if anything happens?
Well... Alright. Yeah, there it is.
You know, 14 is not a bad score for the echo. Or for Dax, for that matter. I'm proficient in
So what you're able to tell Gilhanna is that the flame is a magical fire.
I was gonna say,
sipping hot chocolate as you clutch your cloak tightly around you in the biting snow.
Hot chocolate, yeah, please. It'd be a hot toddy, if anything.
I'm not commenting on what he poured into the hot chocolate after it was served. I'm just saying.
I thought Rolores wasn't there. You mean release? Oh. You just combine the names.
Yeah.
No, I did not pick. I didn't even think about that detect. I just picking things real fast. I was going to say, Ricky could do Divine Sense to see if we can detect good or evil, but again, that doesn't give us a whole lot.
So, again, there is a closed portcullis in front of the green flame.
Cool. I can't for whatever reason unselect my character. But whatever. Wait, no, there we go. I'm trying to keep them exactly 30 feet ahead, almost exactly 30 feet ahead. Can we see through the portcullis?
Yes.
Cool.
Pretty much all that you see on the other side of it is the flames, and depending on what angle you're looking through, you see steps that you presume are leading up to the tower that you're able to see, that you had been able to see over the wall.
I will resummon my echo straight into the green flames.
Okay.
So I can summon it 30 feet away.
Well, can you open the door?
No, but I want to see if anything happens to it before we try anything. Cool.
All right. It,
yeah, but it may have something to do with the door being open, too.
Dacus is backing away. The small cat is slowly creeping up behind everybody.
Is there a lock on it, or is that we can see, or is it just what type of door is it? Just
there you don't see a locking mechanism, but it seems like further inside the structure there's presumably a winch or something that would be used to raise or lower it.
As the cat slowly creeps forward, does it notice anything inside of the portcullis?
It would
it's
notice...
It's not a regular cat? At least... If I have to be a regular cat, it will be a regular cat. But I had chosen a weird cat that has actual senses, like dark vision. Because... Yeah.
It does not...
And tremor sense.
It does not detect anything other than this weird magical flame back there, which kind of precludes its ability to detect anything further on.
Even with, like, tremor sense?
Yeah, it's not detecting anything
cool
moving beyond.
I'm real concerned that if we open the gate, the fire's just gonna spill out. How tall is the wall?
30 feet. Sorry. The walls here and here are 20 feet. The gatehouse is 30 feet with these griffin-like statues on top.
What are those giant statues up front that are probably not actually statues?
Yeah, that's what I was gonna ask about too.
2 15-foot statues of female warriors holding a longsword and shield flank the gates.
Oh, Jax, haven't read the book. Swear. We seek to destroy the evil and swear to uphold the natural law.
So you are essentially reciting the poem thingy?
Not...
Or the oath,
sure.
Rather?
Yeah.
Alright. Nothing happens. Sure. You don't notice any mechanisms or anything that might indicate that they're linked to the door mechanically in any way.
And they move it all.
You don't see anything that would indicate like a way to slide them out of position.
Or turn them, or...
They don't seem to be repositionable.
I didn't say anything about casting ahead of time, so I don't have...
Yeah. Reltash and Jax are likely the only ones that would have noticed.
So, the person who actually is, and then me, who's also playing my own character.
Yeah, so Jax probably would have noticed a small cat moving around while everyone else was focusing on the statues.
To be fair, the cat that I'm... The stats that I'm looking at for my cat, for the cat, are from the Icewind Dale, so it is a cat native to cold areas.
Ooh, look, dinner! Let's kill it!
Cat also has the best senses out of all of us. So did we determine whether or not the cat?
Let's see, you did the shield maiden oath with the one you did, right?
Jax just tried to recite this shield maiden oath. Jax is wondering if it is shield maiden, you have to be a woman to recite it.
Yeah, I was going to say, we asked the shield maidens for help getting through safely. If the last line is my aid to those who seek it.
So they continue to stay motionless, not appearing to be
taking from statues.
Animate, as you look them over.
Do we want to make them? Do we want to animate them?
Question, since it's natural law of the Fae and her allies, Ricky actually being Fae, would he know anything about them?
Go ahead and roll perception, I guess.
The cat's gonna try to climb up onto one of the pillar this area.
Does it have anything that would help it climb a wall?
The climb speed and claws?
Oh, okay. What's the climb speed?
30.
30?
Yeah.
All right.
It does, in fact, have a natural climb speed, so, which is why I'm like, yes, cat. Okay. Cat is useful.
So,
Nat 20, 24.
Okay. All right. Examining the statue very carefully, you do notice markings on the pedestal that indicate to you that these statues have possibly moved in the past, but they appear to be dormant as far as you're able to tell.
You mean that they moved on their own, or that the base of the statues have been moved?
You see basically like cracking around the feet, as if the statues had moved out of position and then back into position.
So I would relay this to everyone but the cat.
Okay.
And whether the cat overheard.
Look.
All right.
So you stick it to place, and that can't help us.
So nothing happens to the foot, but the scratches and scrapes in the pedestal base itself heal and are no longer noticeable. Meanwhile, the cat climbs up on top of the guardhouse. I take it you're having to climb the guardhouse or the wall itself?
Up onto the top of the guardhouse.
Okay. And it finds itself at the base of a statue of a large winged bird. Looks vaguely griffin-like.
I'm rereading all of this story that tells us how this green fire got here.
Yes.
They are aged. They were magically aged really fast.
No, the condition is a thing from a thing.
Does anybody know this? That's why they became statues. Or maybe we should check for detect magic first, but whatever.
Thank you.
Oh, and don't, I just remembered too, my warhorse should be with us. Well, we don't have to take that out yet. When I need it, I'll take it out.
Would we like to get a sentient warhorse? I could get us a sentient warhorse.
I mean, it is pay, so it doesn't necessarily die, but I'm not going to send it through the fire, even though it couldn't pass the gate anyway. Let's see. I heard him breathe, but I don't know if that meant he was reading or what. Damn.
So, nothing happens from the remove curse.
We'll probably have to rest before we get to whatever. Yeah.
The book does say they're cursed.
Maybe, unfortunately, maybe you have to do them both. But
for a restoration spell.
Shields that are on the ground. Is there anything on those? You know, any type of imagery that would.
Unlike the picture, they are actually holding the shields on one arm, sword in the opposite hand. I think these are tokens or something, not the actual appearance of statues, but. There's a there is a symbol on it of two crossed greatswords.
Is it the same on both of them?
Same symbol on both, yes. Yeah, so it's two crossed greatswords under a sun or a star that has like the rays coming off of it and down the shield, and then in front of the rays is the crossed swords.
Well, it's daytime now. I was gonna say, could it be that it's not? Maybe it's dawn.
Because it says both dawn and dusk are components of everything. Did we decide whether or not I can speak telepathically while it's wild shaped?
Yeah, let me double check.
I've looked at a lot of different things and no one can agree.
Yeah.
It's a weird feature for a race, and Wild Shape is really weird about what it actually allows.
Yeah, I have a feeling that most likely you wouldn't be able to because you're... what I remember of Wild Shape, your language changes.
So with Wild Shape, or with my telepathy, I don't... as long as whatever creature I'm speaking with understands at least one language, they understand me.
Right, but I'm going more based on the fact that it is tied to your understanding of language, and when you wild shape, I don't know, I'm leaning towards probably it wouldn't work.
Cool.
Okay.
I doubt it would be that simple because I don't think that would stop the Dark Lord from.
All right. How?
Not fly over the green flames, but fly over the wall to the side. Yeah.
All right. So how high up are you going to fly over this? Okay. All right.
The cat is going to be watching this intently.
As you fly over and land on the other side, the two statues. What? There we go. The two statues come alive, turn, and swoop down after you.
Y'all see this happening?
They let out loud screeches as they start circling and moving towards Gil as he is on the ground on the other side of the fence and rolling his initiative.
Yeah. They didn't notice the cat at all.
Jax may have noticed the little tiny cat.
The birds have not.
Correct. The cat is a small B, a cat, and C.
Tiny and
still on that side of the wall. So, Gil, you hear a loud screech. You look up. You see the statues turning from stone into flesh and blood creatures. Looking over towards you and then swooping down toward you as your feet touch the snow on the other side of the wall. What do you do?
Are you still able to fly?
Not going to help much.
Okay. First bird is going to pursue and is going to swat at you with its talons. Yeah, basically, if it checks anything that's a reaction.
Are we able to see that he's in trouble or hear that he's in trouble?
Jax would probably be able to see it through the gate. I don't know if anybody else is at...
Rel can see it. I'm assuming.
Rel's...
Rel-Tosh.
Probably...
The cat on top of the wall.
Yeah, from up top, knows exactly what's going on. Ricky and Rolise may be able to see the wings, and they probably heard the statues up top coming alive. So they know bad things are happening.
The cat would like to jump down from the wall.
I was going to say, I can't move at all.
Okay. All right. One second. Which side?
Down on to over here.
Yeah. Which side? Okay, down there. And let me get into initiative order. Except not. Not you. Not you. Initiatives. So now you should all be able to roll your initiatives.
So I will say, the cat has an idea, but you're gonna have to work with the cat. Oh, good. The cat goes first, though, so it might work.
All right, Rel-Tosh, you're up.
I will transform back.
All right, one moment. There you go.
And then I will try to make sure that they notice me and try to tell them to, without speaking, like usher them to come close to me and gather around me.
All right. So, Ricky, Jax, and Rel-Tosh, you suddenly see a creature hopping up and down by the wall, waving frantically at you.
She appears to be a young girl. Hard to tell the age because she's really short and really skinny. Mostly appears human, you think, probably. Maybe.
Oh, look at the witch! Push her down the hill! No,
And she's, like, just trying to, like, wave with her hands to come up to her.
Alright,
I guess we would come up to
anything else for Rel-Tosh?
I would like to hold an action.
Okay. For what trigger?
Once everybody gathers around me.
Okay.
I'm going to plant my staff and make it turn into a tree. And I'm going to try to have that tree catch all of us and carry us up to the top of the wall.
Okay, using which ability? Using the staff's...
You can use an action to plant one end of the staff into fertile earth and expand one charge to transform the staff into a healthy tree. The tree is 60 feet tall and has a 5-foot diameter trunk, and its branches at the top spread out 20 feet.
And it grows in one round.
It just says it on. It does it instantly. The tree appears ordinary.
Okay.
I'm happy to do it again later.
You're not having to show it to Gil's brother.
All right. Jax, you presumably don't see this, but you may see Ricky and Rel-Tosh reacting to it.
I will go over and see what they see.
Okay.
And then I guess I'm gonna go stand up close to her.
Alright. Alright. Anything else?
Nope. I dashed to get that far.
Alright. Ricky.
I will move up next to her.
Okay.
And I think I can
Over the wall. It's going to take us a fair bit higher than the wall. But
Birdfoot, I mean Gilhada. All right, so you turn towards the tower. Which has already been described. So, yeah. The door is made of ironbound wood, and as you slam into it to try to open it, you find that it appears to be barred from the inside. But it does give slightly indicating you may be able to force it open, given enough effort. Okay, go ahead and make an athletics check. So you slam your shoulder into the door and you bounce off, and you're not entirely sure because you were looking at the door, but you think the birds may have just chuckled. Okay. Release.
A lot.
Okay. Release is going to join them and
so as you are all now standing around this girl, she plants her staff, a tree forms and starts growing 60 feet up. If
you're going to be well over the thing, but you might be able to hop off in the middle. I don't know, but at least
if you,
we're over the wall.
Yes. If you wish to try to get carried up, go ahead, make a dexterity check to try to grab for the branches as it starts growing up.
If not, you have something that's easier to climb.
You said ability check. We don't have, it's not saving, right?
Correct.
Ooh, Ricky sucked.
Does Voltash have to do that, or is she automatically carried up?
She's automatically carried up.
Cool.
So Jax just barely makes it, her fingertips just barely wrapping around one of the thicker branches, and she is carried up. Ricky and Ralise are stuck on the ground as the tree reaches and kind of looms over the guardhouse.
You've got something that's probably a whole lot easier to if you want to try to climb it, then.
So, yeah. Release, you are still up.
How high is the wall?
The wall is 20 feet. The guardhouse, or the gatehouse, rather, is 30 feet. The tree is 60 feet.
The thing. Would climbing on Ricky count as an action or a movement or interaction?
I would call it an action. To, like, climb up on his shoulders, basically.
Or on his back. Yeah. I was going to try to cast Levitate on both of us. Or on Ricky, that way, if I was hanging on to him.
Grabbing onto him would probably be an action.
What about jumping into his arms?
Same.
Yeah. Remember, Ricky's 9 foot tall, so.
You're essentially doing a grapple.
Yeah. I guess.
I was going to throw down a rope, but.
Well, I mean, the tree would be the climb. And of course, I wasn't even thinking when I was picking spells real fast. I now got it ready to choose when I sleep, Misty Step. But I guess maybe I'll levitate Ricky up to the top, because it says I can move him 20 feet. So that would put him at the top, and he's 9 foot tall, so that would make it easier for him to kind of reach over and help those getting off the tree.
Okay.
All
right, so you float up 20 feet?
Yeah, Ricky does. And it didn't. I must select a token. Hang on. So that, select him. There we go. Cast spell.
So he floats up 20 feet.
Yeah. Up to, and I'd have him against, you know, I'd move him so that he's next to the wall, not like just 20 feet straight up. Or even up into the tree, whichever makes more sense.
Wall. Trust me, the wall will be a lot easier in the long run.
No.
The tree is going to go away soon.
Yeah.
So basically, you tell him to move over next to the wall and ready the action to cast Levitate on him when he does.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else?
No, that will be it. Well, I'll move closer to the wall, too, to make it easier to climb up the tree. And then in turn, so.
Meanwhile, on the other side of the wall,
there's a pair of rocks.
A pair of rocks are getting themselves acquainted with one Mr. Gilana. Swiping with their talons. Rel Tash, you are 30 to 60 feet up in the air.
I'm going to try to now climb and jump over to the, climb down as far as I can and then jump over to the,
Okay. Go ahead and make a dexterity saving throw, because it is a pretty icy surface that you're jumping down onto.
And I am going to be aiming first further, so if I end up falling, I'm going to try to fall to the other side, but...
Okay.
Doesn't matter much.
And so...
Agile, I am not.
you would land and... pick high or low?
High.
You end up sliding the other way and dropping 30 feet onto the ground on the original side.
Cool.
Taking 5 falling damage in the process.
Cool.
Anything else?
That's going to be all. I'll start trying to climb back up the tree.
All right. So you'd be prone. Mostly you would just be using the rest of your movement to basically stand up and walk up to the tree.
Fair enough.
Jax, you are up.
Jax is going to being 30 feet or 60 feet in the air. Summon my echo standing right here.
Okay.
And I'm holding on, you said.
Yeah, you're still holding on to the branches of the tree.
And I'm gonna just try to get myself a little bit better settled.
Okay.
Next turn. I'll deal with this next turn.
Ricky, you are up.
So, I move to the wall.
All right, and then the readied levitate from Rollies would trigger, and I'm assuming the plan was Rollies is grabbing you, and then the two of you float upward together?
Yes.
Okay. So that will be a thing that happens. Anything else?
I mean, can I step onto the yeah. top of it?
Yeah, so if basically you're both going to just step on top and break the
concentration,
yeah,
then
you'd be able to do that, and you would be able to use the spikes, kind of grab onto them to steady yourselves as you try to make your way across this kind of treacherous area up here.
Okay.
So, say you move to there. Anything else?
Unfortunately, do I have a bonus thing? I can't remember that. I don't think there's anything I can do, but let me just make sure. I'm going to summon my spiritual weapon.
Okay.
That's that. And spellbook. Why is it not allowing me to select it? Is it because I got myself selected? Targeted? Okay, to release that. Cast spell, there we go. And it is... It's an axe, isn't it, that I have?
I believe yours is the axe, yeah.
And I will do it 30 feet, I think? Or 20 feet, which would be... Well, no, I'll keep it relatively close, because... And then that would end my turn.
Okay. Galana, go ahead and... So you make it.
Or quarterstaff?
Yeah, probably.
Well, I mean, it could be shape of anything. A club? Shield? What?
Well, usually the shape is associated with your deity that's giving you the ability to cast it. So I would imagine it
made out of all wood.
Yeah.
So staff, maybe a club.
And I mean, it's just an image. It's not actually...
Release. You are up. You have let go of Ricky and are hovering 20 feet up.
Alright. What is that? I don't want to fire upon them, I don't think. Because, I mean... crap. Trying to decide if we want to, because if we fire upon them, then we're attacking them. I want to cast Blink at the end of each of your turns for the duration of the spell. You roll 11 or higher, you vanish from your current plane of existence and appear on the ethereal plane, and at the start of your next turn and when the spell ends, if you're in that, you return to an unoccupied space of your choice that you can see within 10 feet from you. Oh, no, because I'm in the air, and that would put me at least I could put myself on the ground. I thought I could. Well, no, it is more than just one time, so. Now, I better save that till I'm on the ground. Crap. It's not an easy thing to decide.
I mean, I don't know what Fox is doing next, which ought to be fun.
Yeah, I mean, I would probably grapple Ricky's arm for him to kind of lower me on his next turn.
Alright. So... moving forward so that you're basically next to Ricky.
Yeah.
Alright. And I take it no longer concentrating on levitate?
No. Once we got on, we would do that. I wish levitate... I should have gotten Featherfall, but... Again, I did not know this was going to happen.
Welcome back. Anything else for Rollies?
No, that would be it. That was your first one, wasn't it?
That was your first.
You got a 15, so you save.
So, one of the rocks turns around, starts flying back towards its nesting spot, notices two people sitting on top of this side of the wall, flies over to one of them, and targets them and rakes them with its talons.
I am going to do silvery barbs test.
So that does not change because the creature has advantage. Which creature are you giving advantage to?
I'll give it to Ricky.
Okay. And the other rock notices that his brother, friend, who knows, has found food, flies over, and takes a bite at Ricky with its beak, and misses.
How big are these guys? Are they... They're huge, right?
They are.
Cool.
Reltash.
Cool. Reltash, disliking this, is going to cast a spell. And that spell is Conjure Animals. Reltash is going to summon a Quetzalcoatlus? I think is how you pronounce that.
Let's see.
It is the R2, which is the most I can summon.
And so what? Which one are you summoning? The Plesiosaurus?
The giant dinosaur. That I can't pronounce its name. That one.
Oh, that one?
The huge dinosaur, not giant, sorry.
Let's see if I have a stat block for it!
Soon. So soon. Can't quite turn into it yet. Have a couple levels left.
Plutonium and that is in the monster's handbook, right? The monster manual?
Yes. Or no, it says this one says it's in Mordekain.
Mordekainen's Tome of Foes.
It's the newest one. Cause it changed the Monsters of the Multiverse. There is a stat block that is very, very similar in Volas. I'm mostly going to use it as a mount, just because it's huge, so it can pick up me and Jack and anyone else who wants to go over and fly us over the wall. Anyone else want to get on to the giant dinosaur that just appeared?
Yeah, I mean, if it's coming by.
Testing, and there goes two familiars.
Because Release does have a trick that he can use if he gets everyone into a group.
Is this where you're summoning it? Riltash?
Sure.
Alright.
With its speed, once it's its turn, it has to roll its own initiative.
Alright. Go ahead and roll its initiative. You probably cannot.
No, I cannot.
Alright. Initiative.
I get 13.
All right. Anything else for Reltash?
I will order it. Carry all of us who will come to you across the wall, and then telepath. I am ordering it. I'm giving it its orders telepathically.
Okay.
And then defend us from the things. Yeah, that's all.
Alright.
I'll climb into its area so that I can go with it easier.
Alright. Jax, you are up.
Jax is going to switch places with its echo.
Okay.
Then move my echo forward. If I can make my echo move here, I don't know if I can make my echo move there or not. I don't know.
Alright. So it is jumping down onto there.
Yep.
Okay.
And then attacking.
Alright. So, yeah, go ahead and target, attack. See what happens. Alright, so that hits. Doing a little bit of radiant damage, and the rock screams looking at your echo. That attack was through your echo, right?
Yes, now it's going to attack again.
Alright. And that is another hit. For another chunk of damage.
Is it attacking the statue or the creatures?
The creatures.
Okay.
Yeah,
the things that have been attacking people.
Well, I didn't know if you were attacking the statues thinking that maybe it would destroy the creatures.
The statues turned into the creatures.
Yeah, no, okay. There are no statues anymore. Those statues.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, anything else?
No, that's my turn.
Alright. Ricky, you're up.
Alright, so I've got the one targeted, and I'm gonna try casting command.
Alright, now the one that you have targeted is not the one that attacked you.
The one that
Jax has attacked.
Well, it's not an attack spell.
Right. I'm just saying.
But
in case it doesn't matter which one you're attacking. I'm just saying the one that you've targeted is.
Well,
I targeted this one
because it's in the initiative.
Oh, okay.
And I want to command it and say, help.
Okay.
16. I guess then I would take... I can't select my spiritual weapon from... the ground, because the birds are above it. I'm going to change my target then to the one that's been hit, and...
So, just real quick, before you do that, go ahead and make an intelligence check.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Alright. You have a feeling that the bird probably does not know Dwarvish, Common, or Draconic. It has to understand a language you speak in order for command.
Well, okay. Now, technically, because it didn't give me the choice of, since I'm Fey, I could have spoken it in Fey. But that was not one that I was able to choose.
They do not automatically speak Sylvan.
Yeah, they don't have high enough intelligence to speak a language.
Oh. Well, I just thought maybe they were not really birds, as more... just a form, kind of like the druids do. But
even then,
yeah, it's not strictly a bird; it's a construct. But it doesn't have a language capacity.
Okay.
You also probably don't speak. I don't think you speak this Sylvan.
Well, again, there was something they never gave me a choice to choose,
right.
Being Fey.
Yep,
yeah,
fairies don't automatically get it.
Huh?
Fairies don't automatically get it.
Well, his character's a Fey royalty. They don't have a thing that you can choose for Fey.
You automatically get one language of your choice.
Yeah, it would
you were not able to choose Sylvan, though.
Give me one sec. Do you want to replace one of the languages that you have?
Yeah.
Okay. Which one? Draconic? Dwarvish?
Dwarvish, I think.
Okay. Done.
But, I mean, no matter what, it's a moot point because
right.
I can't really do it. But I was trying to, I can't select the birds are on top of the spiritual weapon, so I can't select it to hit the attack. All right.
Now you should be able to select it.
And inventory, and then attack. Did it take the damage? I couldn't tell because I had the thing up.
So yes, that did hit, and it did damage.
All right, and then in turn.
So down at the bottom where you have the tokens along the bottom, you should see the token for the spiritual weapon.
Oh, okay.
If you click it down there, it should take you to your weapons token.
I didn't even notice that was down there.
Yeah. So any of your summons should actually show up down there along with perception or whatever other statistics are set to show. Gohana, you are up. And another success.
Oh, and you were so close to getting a 20, too.
Quetzalcoatlus.
Yeah.
Dino Bird, you're up.
The Dino Bird is going to grab on to Riltash.
All right. Touch. Oops. So where do you want to fly?
First it's going to go over and see if any of the other people want to grab onto.
Yeah, so we'd all get on it.
Alright.
Jax won't. Jax has his own way to the handle.
Alright.
That's going to fly over here, depositing them over here. And well, on now, its way over, it will attack this one.
Alright, so with the passengers clinging on?
It attacks with a bite, so yes.
Okay. Let's go to... And you said it's attacking the one on the right with a bite?
Yes, the one that's already been hit.
Oh, the one on the left.
Or sorry, yeah, I was going to attack the one that already was hit, but it missed.
All right, so it bites at it, it misses. And then...
It's just going to deposit them down, like, over here somewhere.
As close to Gil as you can get us.
Yeah.
Can you get us to Gil? Yeah.
I've got 80 feet of movement, so I'm assuming I've got... I can get most of the way there.
So yeah, it will take you to here.
And it does not provoke opportunity of attacks when it flies out of an enemy's reach.
Okay.
It has flyby.
Alright.
I chose this creature for a reason.
Anything else for Dino Bird?
It will screech at the rocks.
Okay. Rallis, you are up.
Okay, I have a question. Tiny Hut. When I cast that, I can make it so that they can come into it once it's been cast, right?
I don't think so. I think once it...
I thought it allowed you to...
Is it the named Tiny Hut or just Tiny Hut?
It's...
They're identical.
I was going to say that.
Okay.
Oh, you know what? And my character was—I did not realize he has not been updated. The spells—he does not have it on him here.
Okay. Nine creatures can fit inside the dome.
So creatures who are already inside the dome can pass through it.
All other creatures are barred. Yeah. So they have to be in it when you cast it.
Okay. So then I'll—I guess I'll hold that. I will. Can I make it over to Gil? Let's see. I can go 30 feet, so yeah, I can get right next to him. I am 60 feet.
All right, Tiny Head is on your, is on Rolly's sheet now.
All right, oh, yeah, I just realized he does have Featherfall on it. It just was not updated with, trying to think, range 60 feet, I guess. I got Wither and Bloom, but hang on. I am going to cast Wither Bloom on the closest. Oh shit, no, I don't want him attacking me, because I'm already too low. And of course, I don't have the Wither and Bloom. It's my healing is what I was going to do, but I can't do that without attacking something. I want to hold my action until yeah, let me just, I'm going to hold my action till like, can I do it just before Ricky?
What would the trigger for it be?
I guess, oh, maybe it attacking, or the second one attacking someone else. Then I know once their attacks have been used, I can use the Wither and Bloom attack on it.
So, when the damaged one makes an attack?
Yes.
Okay. Anything else?
No, that would be it. Unfortunately, I don't have any healing potions on me, because otherwise I would have done that, and I don't have any type of medicine type of thing. But if I can get anything off of it, I can use it to bring Philly's skill up.
Claw at it and badly miss. Try to attack Ricky. That's talons missing, and that would trigger your.
Yeah, so, and I'll just do it from.
No, it didn't leave my. Didn't leave the whether whatever's range, did it?
What do you mean?
It didn't, I wouldn't get an attack of opportunity.
No, it flew over and then kind of circled back and landed.
And since I can't roll it in the game, I'll do it in D&D Beyond right now. So it has to do a con save of 18.
You don't have Wither and Bloom on the thing?
No, it all was right. One of the new ones that I picked. Then it would take 8 damage.
Alright, let's start. There. And Bloom. Alright, Wither and Bloom should be on Rolise's sheet now.
Okay.
Make sure you target before casting.
So, is it this one that next to Ricky was the one that...
Yeah, this one.
Alright, spellbook. I didn't see it do a roll. The thing came up, but it didn't.
It should be prompting you to place a template where the thing is centered.
Okay, there we go.
And that hits and does damage, but it makes its constitution save.
So, what, it took, what, stun damage?
Yes.
All right, then I will... It was, what, only four damage that it took?
Was more than that.
Okay. So, then that would be transferred. I wish I could split it, but I'm just going to do the 9 to Gil.
Okay. So, Gil, you accept these hit points?
So you roll a hit die and gain the hit die plus those hit points. So you have to roll one of your hit dice, but it lets you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you're higher than I am.
You gained 11, right?
And now the blood splatter should have disappeared.
No, blood splatter happens at half health. All right, anything else for release?
I don't think I have any... No, I don't have any bonus thing, so... That would end turn.
Is going to claw at Dino Bird, hitting it for a decent amount of damage. The other rock is going to make another attack at Ricky, because it does not know where the sphere of death underneath it came from. And it is going to hit Ricky. And Reltash is up.
Cool. Reltash is going
to cast Healing Word on Release.
Okay.
Thank you.
We'll cast it at second level.
Make sure you have Release targeted.
I did not, yeah. Sorry. I targeted the thing. Oops. You get 10 hit points back.
It's a plus.
Run away.
Alright, so, Release got 10.
I added it.
Okay.
Action. Run even further away.
Nope. Stay what? Close. Stay close. Remember, I want to cast something. Okay. The tiny hut.
Cool. In that case,
well, I figured that it'd give us at least 8 hours to come up with something.
Alright, anything else?
I'll hold an attack.
Okay. For what trigger?
If one of those things comes up to us.
Okay.
I don't have my staff, unfortunately.
Jax, you are up.
I'm gonna step forward as far as I can. And I'm going to summon my Echo. And I want to I'm going to try to summon it on one of these things' bats.
All right.
They are large enough that that shouldn't be too much of an issue, I feel like.
All right.
And then the Echo is going to stab at them.
Alright. So the Echo will need to make a dexterity check to make sure it can stand. Say, we'll call it a DC 10. Alright. Makes it. Go ahead and roll the attack. Alright. And that hits.
And second attack.
Also a hit.
And that will be my turn.
Okay. Ricky, you are up.
So, hang on. Let's see, I want to not let me move the spiritual weapon.
Where would you like to put the spiritual weapon?
Next to the one next to me.
All right. Are you able to move it that far? That's about 120 feet.
Oh, these aren't... these aren't the 5 foot. Okay, we're doing the big thing again.
Right, because... yeah, the spiritual weapon's what, like 30 feet, I think?
No, 20, I think.
Oh, 20 feet? Yeah.
Alright, well, I guess then it will just... I'll attack this one. And
all right, and it rolled a 6.
That misses. All right. Now is any movement from this one? I get an opportunity attack, right?
Correct.
Unless
you disengage.
Do I have disengage? I don't think I do.
Disengage is an automatic.
Certain classes can take it.
Everyone has
action.
It.
Oh, okay.
But everyone gets it as an action.
Yeah. All right. Then, yeah, I'm going to disengage. And I am going to move to the group.
All right. And that's your turn?
Yep.
Yelhana. Okay, go ahead and make another athletics check. All right, so you plant your shoulder into it, and you hear the door creaking and starting to crack, and you hear the splintering of wood, but the door just barely holds. All right. Dragonbird.
Dragonbird is going to follow its last order to get these people to safety. So it's going to fly over and grab Jax.
Okay.
And then deposit Jax with the rest of the group. It will make a bite attack at the one that the Echo is attacking as it goes by.
All right, so it will bite at that one and hit. As it flies up towards Jax, does Jax go willingly or try to resist being grabbed? Okay.
Jax has seen it flying everyone else to help to safety.
So then
it'd be really bad if your character was like, "No, you can't save me." But I'm no.
Yeah, right. And because flyby, it doesn't provoke attacks of opportunity.
Okay. So it deposits you there then. Rolly. Rollies.
All right. Question: for a tiny hut, if I do it right next to the building, I guess it's like a dome or something.
Yeah.
Correct.
Could I do it so that the door would kind of be in, so we could still hit the door while we're.
I don't think it can intersect with the door, but
well, I mean, like, could I use part of the wall so maybe I don't get a full dome, it's a half dome, but we're attached to the building?
It only covers 10 feet.
Yeah, it's
but it's enough for all of us to fit into.
Is it?
Yeah, it's yeah.
Yeah, it's
a 10-foot radius is what? 20 feet, isn't it?
The 10-foot radius or 10-foot diameter?
10-foot radius. So it's 4x4. So enough space for 9 creatures, basically. Actually, a little more than that. Surrounded above you, remain stationary.
Well, can we fire through it?
No.
No. But you can... Yeah.
Yeah.
Spells, magical effects can't extend through the dome or be cast through it. You are able to enter and exit as you wish. Dome is opaque from the outside of any color you choose, but transparent from the inside. So, probably you wouldn't be able to intersect the wall, but you would be able to kind of put it in front where you could probably fairly safely pop out, hit the door, and then pop back in.
Okay. So then, yeah, that's what I would be doing.
Okay.
Since it said that we could come in and out, and... Cool.
Everyone but the caster. The caster can't leave it.
What does it say? Oh, we didn't give any available spell slots to it.
Well, it doesn't say anything about the caster. Oh, just as creatures and objects within the dome can move through it freely. Okay.
And you know what? My character is only listed as level 4 in this thing. So, can we do... How long would it take just to do a quick update on my character?
Is everything in D&D Beyond up to date?
Yeah, the spells and stuff like that.
You just want the spells? Give me one second. Hit die. Just not changing powers, not changing.
Yeah, and then it'll... Because it'll change my hit points are actually higher, too.
Right.
That.
All right, you should be updated now.
It did not add up the number of spaces. So, there we go. Did it? Why does he keep saying I have no... There we go. I should have spell slots available for it, but it's not having me.
For which one? Your third level?
Level, yeah.
Alright, how many are you supposed to have?
So, I should still have two. I've only cast one.
How many spell slots do you have?
I have 3 spell slots, and actually I haven't cast one yet, because when I did Wither and Bloom, I did it at level 2, so.
Alright. It should be updated now.
Alright, And I would make it basically so it was like snow covered, so they really couldn't see through it.
Right. So basically, it's white, opaque dome.
Yeah.
Appears there. All right. Anything else?
No.
Okay. Jax, go ahead and make your Echo make a dexterity saving throw.
Give me a second. My Echo's gone.
Oh. Might have popped out from under.
Well, no. As in, it's vanished. It's too far away from me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
It's not gone, as in I can't see it. It's gone, as in... As the thing carried me far away to safety.
And you watch as the rocks attack Dino Bird and tear it apart. And then walk over to the hut and start pecking at it. Is the Wither and Bloom still active?
I think it's, isn't it just a one time?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just a one time, so. It would be nice if it was multiple times.
Alright. So, you all are safely ensconced in your hut. And we will go ahead and end combat there as you cower within your hut. As you are sitting in there, you see the rocks walking around periodically pecking at the dome.
I was intending, if we're just going to be waiting in here, to keep summoning my echo just outside the dome to keep attacking these things.
Well, no, you can have it attack the door. Break the door.
But we don't want to just try to kill the birds?
Wait, is the building stone or is it wood?
Stone.
I was going to let you guys deal with the door as the echo.
Okay. Yeah.
Nails on. I mean, the echo's got nothing better to do.
Yeah.
All right. So, which. Yep. Nope. So which bird is the echo attacking first, and where is the echo?
It's just gonna...
Where's the echo? Top one, bottom one.
Which one is more injured?
Let's see.
I think it's the one to the left.
They're 8 points off from one another. It is...
Close enough that it makes
this one. Yeah, pretty much.
Cool. My echo's there, so it's going to attack that one.
Alright.
For the live stream, so it never picked up my voice. Whoops.
Oh, yeah, I was going to say, the last couple of times, especially your mic, but the one that I missed, I could hardly hear anybody.
Yeah, that was the new mic that I was using. I'm using the old one for these live streams, but using the new one for the single player games that I'm streaming.
Yeah. I mean, since we're not in initiative, can I just have my virtual weapon? Because it'll still be around for a little bit longer, attack the other one.
Sure.
That's essentially, it's just like, I can keep summoning the echo, so it's just going to keep attacking these.
All right.
Well,
so
I have a limited amount on the...
Yeah.
We'll say that between the spiritual weapon and the echo, it takes about 15 minutes, but eventually you are able to kill the two rocks.
Ta-da!
And do we eventually break down that door? while all that was happening.
Girl Tosh is also going to head over and try to see if she can't climb up the wall a little bit.
Okay. Does she have a climb speed, or...
When she's not wild, she does not.
Okay. Then she can try making a dexterity acrobatics check to try to climb. Well, it's mostly about, you know, finding handholds in this icy, freezing cold stone wall. And it will presumably be quite difficult to climb.
Can we see if the statues on the other side have reappeared?
Unless somebody else went over there wants to help me, is you've got like a little girl trying to climb a wall.
Well, what I'm saying is, can we see it through the green flames rather than climb the wall?
Oh, no. She wants to get back to her tree. Because her tree is her staff. Oh. She wants her staff back.
All right. Yeah, Ricky can go over there and boost you up. He's 9 foot tall, so he can push you up quite a bit.
All right. So that would get Reltash about halfway up. Which would cut down the DC a little bit.
Well, that'd get her more than halfway, because
if you're 9 foot and your hands over your head.
Yeah. So that'd get her at least 10, and then however tall she is.
4'11".
The real question is, would my...
So 15 foot.
The real question is, would my celestial revelation, my wings, still be active after I went down and unconscious?
No.
Then it thinks so. Because if it did, I'd be able to just fly her over and then fly her back.
So she climbs a couple of feet and then ends up just sliding right back down.
I really don't want to use my other wild shape.
So is Tiny Hut a concentration?
It is. Wait. No, it's a ritual.
Alright. Then...
No, concentration.
Think we're going to take a short rest soon?
I would recommend...
Well, yeah, what I was going to say, Release can walk over there then and cast Levitate and get you the 20 feet that you need.
Well, not thankfully. And she wants to, then, when she's on top of the wall, she's going to try to reach out and grab her staff, grab the tree and turn it back into a staff.
Okay. Which we will say she is able to do without an issue.
All right. And Ricky will stay down there to make it that she can just kind of drop into his arm. Yeah.
She's not going to bother. She's just going to jump to the ground. It's 30 feet. That's not that much damage.
Well, why'd it kick in?
And the reason why I asked if my rings would still be there is because, one, it's not concentration, and two, it just says 1 minute or until I end it as a bonus action.
Well, he said 15 minutes to kill the rock, so true. It's been past the 1 minute.
Right. Yeah, and plus going down generally cancels any effects and everything else pretty much goes away, and you reset once you come back up. Is anyone still working on the door?
Well, of course, Gil.
Are
is.
You going to do a rest?
Yeah.
Or?
Right. Well, I was going to say what we should do if we get the door open while we have the hut, since we can go in and out of it. If there's something scary on the inside, we can come back in
to the hut, yeah.
To hut while we still have time. And Ricky will use one of his
back-to-back sixes. Points. Wonderful.
It's a healing.
Yeah, that entire time Gil was trying to open the thing.
Is anybody assisting Gil in this endeavor to open the door?
Yeah, Ricky will.
All right. Go ahead, roll with advantage, which is alt.
All right.
And the door persists in being hard to smash down.
I am not rolling good with the athletics.
Give me a second. What is that challenge rating? Ah, no, that's way too high of a challenge rating.
Let's see. Guidance. I wonder... Would athletic skill check and ability check or no? I don't think it is.
What was that? Which one?
Athletics. Would that be considered ability or just regular skill?
Athletics is a skill check.
Okay. Because I was looking at guidance and thinking of casting that on myself.
Guidance, I think, would work on... I think guidance works on skill checks.
Because it says... ability check of its choice.
Are you still having a problem with the door?
Yep.
All right.
That plus this, and that's not going to do shit.
So, what are you doing? A strength check?
It's athletics, which is strength.
Yeah.
Athletics. All right. Ricky. Oh, God, does a 10.
Would you like some help with that?
I have a plus 7 in athletics.
So I got a 10.
Yeah, if you want to give me advantage. Well, yeah.
No, I was thinking about transforming.
Your spiritual weapon would be gone by now, right, Ricky? That's a 1 minute.
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
I wonder. I'm targeting the door. I'm using my silvered morning star, and I miss.
The door that is barred in place deftly sidesteps the morning star.
Jesus.
Raltasha's going to start just like kind of shooing you guys out of the way a little bit.
Okay, I did a 21.
And your fist bounces off the door.
Cool. Raltash is once again going to start kind of trying to get you guys to be further away from the door for a moment. Raltash would like to turn into a rhinoceros.
No, I don't think you can because you would... That may be too big for the hut.
I'm not in the hut.
Yeah,
you'd have to go through the hut to get to the door.
Or over the hut.
I can't.
Well, if you allow her to go over, but yeah.
Well, I was thinking more, it's a dome. Okay, so I don't know how steep the sides are.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anything that's larger than a medium.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, never mind. I'll find a different
animal.
Let me see.
I can't target the door at all. So, but this is... I don't know if it'll let me cast it without targeting.
Hey, I actually rolled 17 on that.
If I do a firebolt at the door...
Well, the 17 hits, and it does damage the door, which kind of shudders and cracks, and you can tell that it is starting to give after that.
Jax will walk up and start attacking the door.
Okay.
With just a regular longsword, because Jax isn't wasting. I'm targeting
sure.
my Echo. I don't think I can target my Echo.
Well, we can both attack it at the same time. I'll use another Alathabar.
You should be able to roll
attacks
without a target since you're not on your
combat.
Since you're not in initiative, but Ricky does finally manage to smash open the door, which bursts inward as whatever it was being barred shut with gives way. Did you all want... Okay,
I was going to say, don't just go rushing in. You know,
right in. And I see this thing and I stop dead right where I am.
Yeah, so... what, you see a creature?
I did. It's vanished now.
The ground floor is bitter cold. While seemingly old, it is certainly not abandoned. Boxes and supplies are neatly stacked. The hearth is prepared for a fire and cooking. A stone staircase rises above. There is a small alcove to the northwest. A floor grate opens to an oblette that drops 20 feet below. A foul odor rises from the oblette. I have no idea how to say that.
Just call it a toilet.
Yeah. Open that new tab, and...
Or for our Great Britain friends, a loo. That creature's
Munstore.
Name... Munstore? Just makes me want to eat some cheese.
Wait a minute, is this 1313 Mockingbird Lane? The home of the monsters?
So, in the corner, you see a figure moving some of the boxes around, and it then turns to face Gilhanna as he enters and kind of regards him with kind of head tilted to the side.
Like a bird.
From where you are, you see that it does have a bird-like beak and appears to be fully covered with leathers and a leather hat. Creature is about 5 feet tall. And it is just standing there looking at Gil.
And as I'm standing there looking right at it and it's looking at me, all of a sudden all the exhaustion from that, all the adrenaline just went away from that last fight, and I fall down to a knee.
What's everybody else doing?
Well, I mean, we're paused for one thing, but also we're 10 minutes till.
Yes.
So, Gil, are you able to go over, or do we have to stop at 9?
I do need to stop at 10 because I work in the morning.
Okay.
And not to mention,
do we
want to
stop here,
so.
Or do we want to go the last 10 minutes?
I'm fine going with the last 10 minutes.
Okay.
Because we can always pick up back up the exact spot where we left off, so.
So, now that we can move, Ricky would try to rush in, since Gil's being foolhardish.
But also, Gil's now on one knee.
And you see this creature standing at the far end, just essentially looking at all of you. Mm-hmm.
We mean you no harm. We were just looking for safety.
And at that, its head kind of lolls to the other side, and it's kind of peering at you over its beak.
I don't know if this thing is intelligent enough to understand us.
I mean, that's rude.
Well, you gotta remember, Gil
is... It's enclosed, So, yeah. It would have to have some intelligence. You don't find a lot of animals running around in clothing.
Unless they are a pet of someone.
Or a druid.
Yep.
Or a were creature. There's actually a fair amount of
were creatures here.
Well, yeah. Again, those aren't just animals. Those are beings.
Yep.
Yes, and we were.
So they would have intelligence.
They never said this was an animal. It said it has a bird-like beak.
And I said,
but Gil was the one
that looked like birds.
Yeah, Gil was the one that said he didn't know if they had intelligence. And I said, well, I don't think an animal would be wearing furniture. Or not furniture, clothing. And then you guys were adding all those other things. And they're like, yeah, but those aren't animals. Those are beings. So
it starts to walk towards all of you. As it does so, you notice that it has a pretty significant limp.
How much of an animal does it look like?
It looks quite bird-like, but it's fully clothed. It's wearing gloves, so you're not quite able to tell from where you are what it might be.
Yeah.
Now, step up and cast Cure Wounds on it.
All right. So, as Ritesh gets there, she sees that it's actually wearing a mask, and the beak is more like the beak of a plague doctor. Plague doctor's mask, as opposed to being a bird creature. So casting cure wounds, nothing happens.
And while she's doing that, I sit down completely right where I'm standing, and I start taking 10 minutes to cast Prayer of Healing at third level. And that's going to pretty much affect everybody, including the Munstor.
Thank you.
And that is going to be 30 HP now. So I'm almost at max, thanks to that. So everybody gained 13 HP, so...
Dax will walk up and say, greetings.
It turns towards Jax and goes, greetings.
Is it repeating it in my voice? Are we dealing with a...
Not in your voice, but its voice is... muffled from the mass.
Like, not like Kenku level mimicry.
No.
Okay.
More. You get a sense of trepidation as it's responding.
We just murdered its defenders.
Like, we're adventurers. I'm Ricky, Gil, Jax, Release. This one we just met. Yeah. Again, we mean you no harm. We're just looking for a safe spot.
He kind of points to himself and says, Munstor.
Other language that would be easier for you?
No, not. Speak to Master. You should.
And while they're communicating, I went back to the door and I mended it using mending the whole time and closed it.
Okay.
Well, can you introduce us to your master? Would you ask him to join us?
His head kind of bobs as he nods and says, "Yes, yes, master, me take, follow." And he starts moving to the stairs.
And I will remind people that the dome is up for several more hours. If things get hairy, run to it.
Whee! And it threw my scream way off.
See a woman on the other side.
I can't bring Reltosh up, but...
Ludmilla? What a name.
It is also 10 o'clock.
Yes.
Yep.
Yep. So I will give you a quick description and then we can pause for the evening. A bubbling cauldron sits in the middle of the room as vapors rise. On one desk, beakers and alchemy are at work. A smoldering fire glows faintly in the hearth. At the far window, a cloaked female stands looking over scrolls and books on a desk. Without turning, aware of your presence, her voice whispers to you. You have come far and managed to pass the fabled Solenka gates. Even Strahd's army was never able to breach the gates. A rare feat indeed. She turns towards you. You notice her flowing dark hair, beauty, and ice blue eyes. Interesting. How, may I ask, did you manage? And
so we didn't breach the gates.
We just went over the gates.
Over them. There were some annoying bird things, but the annoying bird things are dead, sorry.
Here we will pause to be resumed next week.
Alright.
Was there something we could have said to the statues that